So a very good morning to you here at, well, Castlecary Methodist Church and all around the country this morning. It's lovely to see so many of you joining us. We're delighted to have Elizabeth Manley to lead our service this morning. And straight over to you, Elizabeth. Thank you for leading us in worship this morning.
I just want to say welcome, Jessica, who has managed to get through from Chippenham, the dark beyond in Chippenham. So hi, Jess. We're glad that you can come too. Mum and Dad said that you were struggling a bit this morning. So hello, everybody. Welcome to our Zoom service. We're going to hear a psalm in a minute, and I love this psalm. People often say it's a harvest psalm because it speaks of God's provision. But I think that we can listen and hear about God's provision any time of the year. So Sandy is going to read to us from Psalm 65.
This is Psalm 65, verses 8 to 13. You make the dawn and the sunset sing for joy. You care for the land and water it. You greatly enrich it. The stream of God is filled with waters. You provide their grain. And so you have established it. You drench its furrows, penetrating its ridges. With rain you soften it. Its growth you bless it. You crown the year with your bounty, and your wagon paths drip with richness. They drop on the pastures of the wilderness, and the hills gird themselves with joy. The pasture lands put on flocks, and the valleys clothe themselves with grain. They shout in triumph, and they even sing. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Sandy. I love that bit about the valleys clothing themselves with grain. They shout in triumph. They even sing. I can't imagine how it will feel when church is open and we can't sing. At least on Zoom, we can sing our heart out. So that's what we're going to do this morning. We're going to join in praise and celebration of God's provision and his love as we sing, "Come on and celebrate."
Shout your praise.
I don't know about you, but I'll probably be singing that all day now. And what a wonderful thing to sing. So let's pray together. Father God, we thank you that you love us and that we can feel and share that love every day of our lives. We thank you for the gift of each other, for friends and for family. We thank you for our Zoom service this morning, for all who are sharing it and for all whose technological ability helped to bring it to us. We thank you, Lord, for phones and computers, for Zoom and Teams and Skype and FaceTime, making it possible for us to see one another, even during this time of isolation, lockdown and distance. Help us to connect with others, Lord, that through us they may feel your love and know your provision for them. They may also be assured of the joy of your presence with them also, we ask. Forgive us, Father, when we turn away from you, when we let fear rule our lives and think only of ourselves, when we think that we know best, when we become so insular that we forget the needs of others. Help us, Lord, to be better people, people who support and share with others, so that we may all carry the light of your love with joy, and others may be warmed by it. Amen. We're going to hear our reading in a second, and it's a reading that's a very familiar story to all of us. But I don't know about you, every time I read it, and especially when I've had to preach on it, I do manage to find something different in it. If you really read through this reading, if you really listen to it, there are so many aspects, so many different aspects you can pick out to think about. So we're going to ask Annette, there she is, to read to us from Matthew. Thank you, Annette.
Matthew 13 to 21. When Jesus heard what had happened, he withdrew by boat privately to a solitary place. Hearing of this, the crowds followed him on foot from the towns. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them and healed their sick. As evening approached, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a remote place, and it's already getting dark. Send the crowds away so that they can go to the villages and buy themselves some food." Jesus replied, "They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat. We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish," they answered. "Bring them here to me," he said. And as he directed the people to sit down on the grass, taking the 5 loaves and 2 fish and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. They all ate and were satisfied. The disciples picked up 12 baskets full of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000, besides women and children.
Thank you, Annette. We're going to use our imaginations this morning, and in our imagination, we're all going to zoom away from Zoom. We're going to beam ourselves up to another time and another place where social distancing and coronavirus don't exist. Wouldn't that be absolutely wonderful? So hello again, we've arrived. What a beautiful sunny day. What a lush green field. And there are so many people here. Some estimate over 5,000. Isn't it amazing how we all seem to sit together? The knights are here, and the bakers, the Fords, and the cooks, and Judith. And they've even brought the little Daxies, Freddie and Winnie, And there's Sandy and Maggie and Pat and Annette. Everybody's here. And our friends from Somerton, Barry and Val and Trisha and Anna. And look, Ken and Louise are here from Colchester. What a good turnout from the circuit and beyond. Let's give each other a wave. Well done, everyone. And we've waited so long because we've come here today to listen to this most inspirational speaker. And here he comes right now. Well, I don't know what I expected, but I thought he'd be dressed differently. I thought he'd be taller somehow. He's a very ordinary looking guy, a bit like you and me, really. Okay, well, let's see if he can hold a crowd. Let's see if what he has to say is different from anything we've heard before. Not too much pressure then. From the moment that he starts speaking, the children who were playing and squabbling noisily amongst themselves stop. The adults talking, laughing, sharing the latest gossip stop. The dogs who were running around barking at everyone stop. You can almost hear a pin drop. Somehow we're all transfixed by his presence. There does seem to be something really different about him. He's surrounded by some sort of light. And we hang on to every word that he says. We can't get enough. We want to hear more and more. And there's excitement and wonder and expectation, but there's also that peace somehow, that quiet, that stillness, even in this large crowd. Everyone's face is on him. And everyone looks so full of joy. We've all got so many questions, but we've also got so many answers. Suddenly things become clear. And now what's he doing? Hang on. That man who came on sticks has just thrown them away. He's walking unaided. It would be unbelievable if you hadn't seen it with your own eyes. He's completely healed. Suddenly we realise how time has flown whilst we've been watching and listening to this captivating man, and it's starting to get dark. And I don't know about you, but I'm quite hungry. Just at that point, someone comes out and tells the crowd, sorry, but there's no food provision here. But if we want to anything to eat, we'll have to go and get it for ourselves. But where? There's nothing for miles. We want to hear more. We're hanging on his every word. He's got us all in the palm of his hand. We don't want him to stop yet. Then the knights kindly offer to go and get some food. Thanks, David. I'll get everybody's order. Okay, so if you can find a supermarket, we'll have some sandwiches, please. 5 BLTs, 4 ham, one with no mustard, 7 chicken sandwich, chicken salad, 3 with no mayo, 15 packets of crisps, 4 plain, 3 cheese and onion, and 8 crispy bacon, but they must be Walkers. Hang on, Craig wants some chips. Not those skinny fries, but the nice, big, thick, chunky ones that you get in the chip shop. Well, there must be a chippy round here somewhere. And do you know what? I could absolutely murder a chicken korma, but it's got to be with pilau rice. They're so good, our young people. So that's David to the supermarket, Tim to the chippy, and Steve, could you find an Indian takeaway somewhere, please? Shame, really. By the time they queue to get out of the car park and actually find these places, they'll miss a lot of it now. And I do hope Steve's not going to be too long, because it's not very nice eating cold chicken korma. But hang on, Don't go, guys. There is food after all. There's loads of it. Someone's got it wrong. Come back and sit down. It's coming now. You know, some sceptics doubt that this event really happened. And they say at best it was a story told to illustrate God's love and God's provision for us. I don't know what you believe about it, but I believe it did happen. I believe it happened because I believe in miracles. I believe that all things are possible to God. I do believe that Jesus took the bread and the fish and gave thanks and blessed it, and there was indeed more than enough to feed everyone there. You know, the recounting of this story illustrates more than God's love for us. It reinforces his physical provision, enough for all in this world if we choose to share what we have. And not only does he feed us with food, but also by his word, if we choose to listen. Let's imagine from one moment if there had been no loaves and no fishes. If we had all had to go and find food. Some people would have gone and decided not to come back. The possibilities to talk to others and share stories in that field would have been lost. The possibilities for the making of new and supportive friendships would have been lost. Perhaps the possibility of knowing Jesus, of knowing his love and compassion, his protection, his direction, and his teaching would have been lost. You see, we complicate our lives by trying to be in control. Then we worry because in reality we know that we're not in control. How much easier our lives would be then if we put our trust and faith in our God who always provides. May we all, especially at this difficult time, rest in God with joy and trust in our hearts. Put our hope firmly in him, because he, in his compassion, will provide whatever we need. Amen. Without trust in God, we are all in darkness. So we're going to sing again together. Longing for light, we wait in darkness.
Your own, your holy people.
Now we join together and offer our prayers for other people. So let's pray. At this very moment, when we are here together, safe, fed, and loved, someone is struggling to stay alive. Someone is about to lose the person they love. Someone is struggling to provide food for their family. Someone is struggling to find meaning in their life. In the silence, let's pray for them in their struggle. At this very moment, when we are here together, someone is afraid of the loneliness they face. Someone is depressed because of isolation. Someone is orphaned and fears being alone. Someone is terrified of the bombs that have fallen and gunfire on the streets. In the silence, let's pray for them in their fear. At this very moment, when we are here together offering worship, someone is praying in hiding. Someone is too afraid to profess their faith. Someone is losing their faith. Someone is being abused because of their faith. In the silence, let's pray for them to receive God's strength. At this very moment, when we are here together, God knows our questions. He knows our doubts, our mistakes, and our sinfulness. He knows our self-centeredness and our pride, our temptations and weaknesses. So in the silence, let's pray for continued love and guidance for ourselves. at this very moment, and every moment that we are alone or together, God is lovingly present to every part of his creation and every person in it. He is shaping us, encouraging us, and persuading us. Sometimes he's delighted in us, and other times he's despairing of us. But he'll never leave us and never give up on us. And we ask for his help for us and the world. God answers our prayers. What a wonderful God. Now let's share the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God's goodness and love mean that he sends us into the world with joy in our hearts. So we're going to be joyful as we sing our last song. If you want, you can dance in your chairs, you can clap your hands, but please sing with joy. You shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace.
You shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace, and the mountains and the hills shall break forth before you. There'll be shouts of joy, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands. And the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and you'll go out with joy. You shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace, and the mountains and the hills shall break forth before you. There'll be shouts of joy, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands. And the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands, and you'll go out with joy.
Well done, everyone. Before our blessing, I'd like to thank everyone who's helped in this service, for David, who's provided the music and everything, even though he's away, I think. I hope you're having a lovely extended wedding anniversary. For Tim Ford, who's been patience personified with me this week as I've sent my order of service all over the place to everybody that shouldn't have it and then couldn't send it at all, and all my technical disability. Thank you to everyone who's read. Thank you for everyone who's joined us in worship. So let's pray now. Go now with laughter in your eyes, a smile on your lips, and a song in your heart. Go with merriment in your soul and share the love and joy that God has given you. Amen.
Thank you very, very much, Elizabeth, for your service this morning. It was absolutely fab.
Thank you.
Good stuff. You even managed to control your clock in time with your prayers, which I thought
was... I know. Well, when it started, I thought, well, I'll have to have a longer silence now.
No, that was excellent stuff. Thank you very, very much indeed.
Thank you.
Next week, folks, continues the Manly theme. It will be Craig with us next week at 10:30 here on Zoom. There will be coffee after the show, so please stay and have a chat and some coffee, and enjoy the rest of your days. Hope the sun comes out for you all, and we will see you next week, 10:30, here for Worshipping God with Pastor Kerry Methodist Church. Thank you all.
And I also, David, add my thanks to everybody that's made it possible to do what we do week in, week out. It's quite remarkable how we're doing it. And thanks to everybody in the circuit that started to gather here on our Zoom service. Lovely to see so many from around the circuit. Welcome, Celia. You made it this morning. Well done. I just want one final thing of thanks is to Annette Pierce. Thank you for, she held an impromptu social distance gathering to raise funds for the church and has raised quite a sum of money. I will get it to Steve. Have you stopped isolating yet, Steve? For you? Yeah, okay, so I'll get the money to Steve with the usual receipts. But many thanks to Annette for all that she did. Off the cuff, she felt led by God to do it. And thank you for raising funds for our church in this time of need. Hope everybody else enjoys the day. So thank you all.